Welcome back to Chem Help ASAP. As we talk about SN1 reactions with alkyl halides, almost all these reactions fall within a category called solvolysis reactions. So what is a solvolysis? Well, solvolysis literally can be broken down to say solvent cutting. And what are we cutting? We're cutting a bond or breaking a bond. So we're breaking bonds in the presence of a solvent. So I've drawn a model reaction, and we'll walk through this mechanism, talk about why we call this solvent cutting or solvolysis, or sometimes people use it as an adjective, solvolytic process, solvolytic reaction. So here's our solvent. It is ethanol. And ethanol is, it's electron rich. The oxygen has electron density, but it's not really electron rich. This is going to be a nucleophile, but it's going to be a weak nucleophile. It's not a bad thing. It's a good thing for an SN1 to have a weak nucleophile. Now, here is our alkyl halide. It's a tertiary halide, and that's good to help the loss of this halide. Because when we break that bond, we are going to form a carbocation. And that carbocations, they're not great species to make because they don't have a full octet. So this molecule, the halide, starts completely stable, and yet we're asking it to form a carbocation. So why would this occur? Well, one, we have a fairly good leaving group, chloride, and the carbocation we're making is pretty good. It's a tertiary carbocation. That's about as good as we can get. So this is our intermediate. What else is good for this carbocation? Well, we use ethanol as our solvent, an alcohol solvent. And this is a solvent, it's called a polar protic solvent, meaning it has protic, it has an OH bond, and polar because we've got this electronegative oxygen, there's a lot of polarized bonds, there's a lot of unevenly distributed electron density in solvents like ethanol and methanol and water. And those are our common solvents for solvolytic process. So in the upper right, we'll use, typically this applies to water and the alcohols. I'm only going to write methanol, but it also applies to ethanol, propanol, you name it. So these polar protic solvents help to stabilize the formation of these charged species in solution. Charged species like carbocations and halides as leaving groups. Now, once this carbocation forms, this is a very strong electrophile. It's highly reactive. It doesn't have a full octet. And what's going to happen is our ethanol, our weakly nucleophilic ethanol, will attack that carbocation, will form a new carbon-oxygen bond. Now we've really completed our substitution. The chloride has been replaced by what? By ethanol, which is our solvent. So our solvent has replaced the halide. And now all we have left, we have a little charge housekeeping to perform. Our solvent, which is weakly nucleophilic because it's a little bit electron rich. Well, it's also weakly basic, and we need a base to pluck that hydrogen off of our oxygen, and that gets us to our product. So this is a solvolytic reaction in which we take our alkyl halide, we treat it with a polar protic solvent like water or ethanol or methanol or any of the alcohols, and that allows this carbon-halogen bond to break to form a stable carbocation, if we can form a stable carbocation, and that'll be attacked by our solvent molecule.